Hello students, here are some of the important questions for IPE exam which are going to be held in October, that is from 25th of this month. So I have discussed few important questions. They are very important. So here is a brief explanation about the question. So from the atomic structure of chapter 1, the very important question of 8 marks is, write about the quantum numbers and explain their significance. So edaithe manaku IPE exams avabothunnayo October 25th nundi dan gurinchi konni important questions discuss cheyadam jarigindi ikkada. So indulo main points meer nerchukoni rasnattaithe you are going to get the good marks. So children, follow avvandi clear ga. The points evaithe discuss chesano adi clear ga ardham chesukoni raayadaniki prayatnam cheyandi. So here is the first question. Ee question chudandi. Write about the quantum numbers and explain their significance. ఈ క్వశ్చన్ ప్రతిసారి కూడా మనకు అటామిక్ స్ట్రక్చర్ లెసన్లో ఖచ్చితంగా అపియర్ అవుతూ ఉంది ఎగ్జామ్ పాయింట్ ఆఫ్ వ్యూ. సో మనం దీన్ని ఎలా ఎక్స్ప్లెయిన్ చేయొచ్చు క్వాంటమ్ నంబర్స్ గురించి, దాని సిగ్నిఫికెన్స్ గురించి చూద్దాం ఇప్పుడు. ద బిహేవియర్ ఆఫ్ అన్ ఎలక్ట్రాన్ ఇన్ అన్ యాటమ్ ఈజ్ డిస్క్రైబ్డ్ మ్యాథమెటికలీ బై వేవ్ ఫంక్షన్ ఆర్ ఆర్బిటల్. సో క్వాంటమ్ మెకానిక్స్ tells us that three quantum numbers are required to distinguish atomic orbitals precisely. So what are they? They are principal quantum number, angular momentum quantum number, it can also be called as azimuthal quantum number. Next one is magnetic quantum number. These quantum numbers describe the energy level of an orbital and define the shape and orientation of the region in space where the electron will be found. Next, the fourth quantum number, known as the principal quantum number, is needed to specify the direction of the spin of the electron in an atomic orbital. So now we'll explain all this four quantum numbers. Now look at the first quantum number, children. Principal quantum number, it is given by Niels Bohr and denoted by small n. It is used to represent the orbit in which the electron is located. The different values of n are for K, L, M, N shells are 1, 2, 3 and 4 respectively. The value of N also helps to determine the size and energy of the orbits. As the value of N increases, its energy and size increases. So the maximum number of electrons that can be present in an orbit is given by 2n square. So here we'll use this formula and calculate the number of electrons present in each shell. So when n value, that is principal quantum number value, is 1, means when we calculate in this 2 into n square, here n we have taken as 1, so 1 square, 2 into 1 square is nothing but 2 electrons, they are present in the first shell, that is K. Next, when we take n as 2, when we calculate in the second shell, there are 8 electrons in the L shell. Next, when n is 3, it is 18 electrons in the M shell. When n is equal to 4, that is 32 electrons are present in the N shell. So this is about principal quantum number. Next, second quantum number is azimuthal quantum number or angular momentum quantum number. It is given by Sommerfeld and denoted by small l. The value of l gives the sublevel or subshell in which the electron is located. It has values from 0 to minus n minus 1. If at all n is equal to 1 means n 1 minus 1, that is 0. So the value will be 0. Next, so here we'll see value of L. When it is 0, L value is 0 means it is having S. This is subshell. And next, when L is equal to 1 means it is P. 2D, 3F, like this it continues. So it is also used to determine the angular momentum of the electron and shape of the orbital in which the electron is located. So an orbital with L is equal to 0, it is S orbital. As we have seen here, when L value is 0 means it is S orbital. It is spherically symmetrical in shape. Next, when L is equal to 1, it is P orbital and it is dumbbell in shape. When L is equal to 2, it is D orbital and it is in double dumbbell shape. When L is equal to 3, it is F orbital, four-fold dumbbell. So this is about azimuthal quantum number. Next is, third one is magnetic quantum number. It is given by Lande and denoted by small m. The value of m gives the orbital in which the electron is present. The different values of m for a given values of l ranges from minus l to plus l, including 0. And the total number of values is equal to 2l plus 1. So, here we'll see when l value is 0, that is s orbital, the values of m are 0. When l value is 1, then we have p orbital, which has 3 p orbitals, minus 1, 0, plus 1. These are the values of m when it is p orbital. And when it is d orbital, we have 5, that is dxy, dyz, dxz, dx square minus y square, dz square. So we have values from starting from minus 2, minus 1, 0, plus 1 and plus 2. So it tells us about the orientation of different orbitals in a sublevel. Next we'll see n, l, m values in different shells. When k, when n value is 1, it is first shell k, l value is 0, m value is also 0. Next, when we take 2, this is a second shell, l is equal to having two values 0 and 1, m has 0 and minus 1, 0, plus 1. Next, in the third shell, m, when n is equal to 3, it has 3 L values 0, 1, 2. So when it is 0, 0. When the L is 1, minus 1, 0, plus 1. When L value is 2, minus 1, 0, plus 1 and plus 2. Like this we have to give the quantum values. Next we'll see spin quantum number. So fourth one is the spin quantum number. It is given by Uhlenbeck and Goudsmit. It is denoted by small s. Its values are plus half for clockwise spinning electron and minus half for anti-clockwise spinning electron. So it defines the orientation, direction, clockwise spinning of the electron and anti-clockwise spinning of the electron. So here is a simple table for showing all the four quantum numbers and the importance, their significance. We'll see each one of them. Principal quantum number, it is denoted by small n. The values are starting from 1 to infinity. So the importance of this quantum number is energy of the orbit. Second one is azimuthal quantum number, denoted by small l. So the value starts from 0 up to n minus 1 values. Next, it gives the shape of the orbit. Next, third one is a magnetic quantum number denoted by small m. The values are from minus L to plus L. So it gives the special orientation of the orbitals. And the last one, fourth one, is a spin quantum number denoted by small s. So the values are plus half or minus half. So it gives the direction of spin of the electrons. So this is all about the quantum numbers. Okay, children, thank you.